Hello student, today we see the problem based on poles and zeros of transfer function. Okay, so this is the problem for a given transfer function is this ks plus 6 upon s, s plus 2, s plus 5, s square plus 7, s plus 12. Okay, then find out the poles, zeros, characteristic equation and pole zero plots. Okay. So see in answer, firstly we write the given transfer function, that is transfer function is equals to k s plus 6 upon s, s plus 2, s plus 5 and s square plus 7s plus 12. Okay, after that first term, that is poles, we have to find out. Okay, in poles, firstly you know that the denominator term will shows the number of poles, so write denominator equation, that is s, s plus 2, s plus 5, s square plus 7s plus 12. Okay, equals to 0. Okay, denominator equate equals to 0. After that, then s is equals to 0, then s plus 2 equals to 0, then s plus 5 is equals to 0. Okay, then the last equation is s square plus 7s plus 12 is equals to 0. Okay, in this first of all find out the equation. On the basis of this, it is already find out that s is equals to 0. From this we find out s is equals to minus 2. From this s is equals to minus 5. Okay, on the basis of this equation we find out, that is write the equation is here, s square plus 7s plus 12 is equals to 0. Okay, then use factorization method. What is the factor of this equation? That is s plus 3 and s plus 4 equals to 0. Already this factorization method we'll study in our previous classes. Okay, in 10th or 12th class. Okay, so again equating 0, that is s plus 3 is equals to 0 and s plus 4 is equals to 0. Yes, then after that then s is equals to minus 3, then s is equals to minus 4. Okay, then total poles will be, the poles are s is equals to, first poles it is s is equals to 0, then minus 2, then minus 5. Okay, then after that minus 3, minus 4. Okay, these are the poles. Then after that we find out the zeros. Then second it is zeros. Already know that the numerator term equate to 0, that is the transfer function of zeros. So write numerator term k s plus 6 is equals to 0. From that equation we find out, that is s plus 6 is equals to 0, then s is equals to minus 6. So zeros is s is equals to minus 6. Okay, after that we find out the characteristic equation. We see characteristic equation क्वेश्चन कैरेक्टरिस्टिक इक्वेशन, ओके, द कैरेक्टरिस्टिक इक्वेशन इज फाइंड आउट फ्रॉम द डिनोमिनेटर टर्म. ओके, सो राइट अगेन द डिनोमिनेटर टर्म दैट इज एफ ऑफ एस इंडिकेशन दैट इज कैरेक्टरिस्टिक इक्वेशन. इट इज एस एस प्लस टू एस प्लस फाइव एस स्क्वेयर प्लस सेवन एस प्लस ट्वेल्व देन अगेन इक्वल टू जीरो. ओके, आफ्टर दैट सिंप्लीफाइज दिस इक्वेशन बाय मल्टीप्लाइंग वन बाय वन ब्रैकेट. फर्स्टली आई मल्टीप्लाई दिस ब्रैकेट ओनली, सो राइट एस स्क्वेयर प्लस ट्वाइस एस इज हियर. देन दिस ब्रैकेट विल बी सेम एज इट इज दैट इज एस प्लस फाइव एस स्क्वेयर प्लस सेवन एस प्लस ट्वेल्व इक्वल्स टू जीरो. ओके, आफ्टर दैट आई मल्टीप्लाई दिस ब्रैकेट इन टू दिस, सो वॉट विल मल्टीप्लीकेशन. फर्स्टली एस स्क्वेयर विल बी मल्टीप्लाइड बाय बोध दी टर्म, आफ्टर दैट टू एस विल बी मल्टीप्लाइड बाय बोध दी टर्म. ओके, सो एस स्क्वेयर मल्टीप्लाइड दैट इज एस क्यूब प्लस फाइव एस स्क्वेयर प्लस दैट इज टू एस इंटू एस दैट इज टू एस स्क्वेयर प्लस मल्टीप्लीकेशन फाइव इंटू टू इट इज टेन एस. देन दिस ब्रैकेट विल बी सेम एज इट इज इक्वल्स टू जीरो. ओके, आफ्टर दैट मल्टीप्लाई दिस ब्रैकेट इंटू दीज टर्म्स. ओके, सो फर्स्टली आई मल्टीप्लाइड एस क्यूब टू दिस वन, देन द टर्म्स आर एस रेस टू फाइव फर्स्ट टर्म प्लस एस रेस टू सॉरी सेवन एस रेस टू फोर. देन आफ्टर दैट प्लस ट्वेल्व एस क्यूब प्लस आफ्टर दैट आई मल्टीप्लाइड द फाइव एस स्क्वेयर टू दिस ब्रैकेट. देन वॉट विल हैपन दैट इज फाइव एस रेस टू फोर प्लस थर्टी फाइव एस रेस टू क्यूब प्लस सिक्सटी एस रेस टू स्क्वेयर. ओके, प्लस आफ्टर दैट आई मल्टीप्लाइड टू एस स्क्वेयर टू this bracket, then what will happen that is 2s raised to 4 plus 14s raised to cube plus 24s square. Okay, after that last term I have multiplied this bracket, so what is the term? That is 10s cube plus 70s square plus 120s. Okay, after that we arrange this in order of higher order to lower order. Okay, then see the highest order will be s raised to 5. Okay, so firstly see the s raised to 5 terms is only 1, so write s raised to 5. After that s raised to 4 terms, this one s raised to 4 s raised to 4 then this one s raised to 4, then what will be the addition 7 8 9, okay, means 14 s raised to 4. Okay, after that we see the s raised to 3. This is s raised to 3, this is also s raised to 3, this is also s raised to 3, This is also s raised to 3. Okay. Then what will be the addition? It is 71 s cube. After that, square. This is the square. These one square terms. Okay. So what will be the addition? That is 154 s square plus only s term, that is 120 s is equals to 0. Okay. This is our characteristic equation. Okay. This is a characteristic equation of given transfer function. Okay. After that, the fourth parameter we have to find, that is poles, zeros, plot. Okay. We want to plot pole zero values. So firstly, we draw a y-axis, x-axis. Okay. On x-axis, we write real sigma. Then on y-axis, we write imaginary jw. Okay. Minus jw. In this side, minus sigma. Okay. Firstly, this one is the 0, then minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, minus 5, and minus 6. Okay. This is the S plane. Okay. Then we have to plot the poles and zeros. We know that our poles are, that is, okay, see, these are our poles that we find out. So it will draw on this plot. So first one is the zero. Okay, the poles will be indicated as a cross sign, then minus 2, then minus 5, okay, then minus 3, minus 4. Okay, these cross values signs will be poles. Okay, then this is our zeros, it is minus 6. Okay, zeros will be indicated as a circle, so that is, this is our zeros. Okay, this is the poles and zeros plot. Okay, so today's problem will be sorted completely. So thank you.